Mom. Good morning. Good morning. If everyone could please take a seat, we're going to get started. Good morning. As always, it is a joy to be here today with you at one of our favorite events of the year. For those I haven't met, I am Teresa Tudor, the Senior Manager for School and Family Partnerships. This has to be one of the best jobs in our school system. It is my privilege to be able to work with so many wonderful volunteers. I still am amazed each year at the number of people and programs all aimed at making a difference for our students. You can come on. I love being able to host an event to celebrate all that you do. So once again, welcome to our annual Volunteer Recognition Tea. It takes a lot of dedicated people to host the tea each year, and I want to recognize our wonderful staff in the Office of School and Family Partnerships and Partnership Development and Marketing, and our director, Carol Ann McCurdy. If you all could stand, please, they're right here. Thank you all for your hard work, and they were here last night as well, setting up with me, so I really appreciate everything that everyone does to make this a success. The volunteer programs in our schools are committed to making sure we do more than just provide a basic education. Yes, these programs start with literacy, math skills, and other academic goals, but they never stop there. Our volunteers work with students in an incredible and infinite number of programs, from gardening to mentoring to organizing weekend food programs. They sponsor clubs like drama, robotics, and running. They serve as room parents and field trip chaperones. If you can think of it, some school somewhere is running a program to do it. And it is our pleasure and our honor to take the time to recognize all of the time and effort given to our students and our schools. We have a full program today, but before we get started, I wanted to make sure we recognize Lydia Gonzalez, who is our music resource teacher, for taking the time to share her talents with us this morning. Lydia is going to share one more number with us today.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for everything that you do on behalf of all of the AAC dance employees. And so on behalf of the children that you help and serve every day, this song is for you. Thank you.
Thank you, Lydia. I would like to introduce our superintendent, Dr. George Arlotto. I would like to also remind you that Dr. Arlotto is one of our greatest supporters. He knows that school success takes all of us. In fact, if you visit our website, please take the time to look at our strategic plan. It starts with our driving values, values to be used in all planning for future years. The very first of these values reminds us that everyone in the Anne Arundel County Public Schools family fosters student growth. Without further ado, let me present Dr. George Arlotto.
Good morning. Good morning. Lydia, thank you. Beautiful way to start the morning. Thank you so much. Teresa, and to your team, thank you very much. This continues to grow. We're going to have to maybe move this to the Comcast Center next year because we're running out of space. Thank you to you and your team. You do a fabulous job. I do want to thank our board members. Last night was a special night for me in that the board, the board approved my contract and I get to return. I get to be with you for another 4 years. Thank you. I probably wasn't a very good negotiator because from the very outset as we were negotiating the contract, I said, I'm not looking anywhere else and I don't want to be anywhere else. Not probably the best way to start contract negotiations, but it's the truth. I'm delighted to be back. So to Mrs. Korbelak and President Humner, Vice President Gilliland, thank you very much. I'm delighted to return. I do not want to be anywhere else. I do not want to work anywhere else. This is a community that cares about children. I do want to take a quick minute to recognize two of our leadership team that will be retiring this year, Dr. Kathy Kubik and Ray Bebo. First for everything, Ray. These are, I got to, as I was thinking about my remarks driving up this morning and thinking about these two incredible educators and their time and energies over many, many decades, I'm having a hard time thinking about doing another 4 years without having them by my side. Their good humor, their focus on students, their focus on data, is absolutely extraordinary. And so know that you will be missed. We'll be able to find replacements, but we'll really never be able to replace you. And so we thank you for everything you've done over the years, your commitment to children, your commitment to this school system, your commitment to this team is recognized, and you will be missed. So I thank you for everything you've done. Thank you. Get closer to the microphone. Okay. Oh, it's on. Okay, got it. I'm sorry. So this really is a great event every year, and I'm thrilled to be among wonderful people who share the values that drive our new strategic plan, especially the belief that everyone has a role to play in fostering student growth. You are an important part of the effort to provide an engaging and supportive environment that our students need to reach their potential. Our strategic plan can be summed up in three words: relationships, rigor, and readiness. We can and do make a difference each day because we work so hard to help our students succeed. That work is predicated first and foremost on relationships. Those in our classrooms and in our communities, we can't have rigor and readiness if we first don't have relationships. You play a critical role in those relationships, and I know that you are just a small portion of the more than 17,000 volunteers who worked in our schools this year. I also know that you represent a portion of the total hours given. It's hard to imagine, but volunteers this year gave over 450,000 hours of volunteer work. That is truly awesome. I'm sure you know that our teachers, staff, and students appreciate the time that you give. But did you ever stop to think about how valuable that gift of time is to our students? Well, I was curious about this, so I went on, as always, I Googled it, went to the internet, and if you go to an independent sector website, you will find that the estimated value of volunteer time in the state of Maryland is currently $27.50 an hour. Take a moment to think about the time you personally gave. If you were to add all of that up, the value across our county is about $12.4 million. Thank you. We all know, however, that it is not about the money, it's about the time you give to our students and our schools. When we think about you, we know the real value of that time, and it's priceless. Our school system continues to achieve and to succeed, and much of that success is due to your efforts. So, I thank you for your generous gift of our students. Please enjoy today. You have certainly earned it. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Arlotto. We are so glad that you could join us today. We are also privileged to have with us members of the Board of Education, and I'm going to introduce the president, Ms. Hummer, Ms. Julie Hummer, and she's going to bring greetings from the board, and she's also going to introduce the other board members that are present.
Good morning. Let me introduce Mr. Terry Gilliland, who's Vice President of the Board, and Ms. Stacy Korbelak. So, and on behalf of all of my colleagues on the board, thank you. And we are so grateful for all you do. I began my journey onto the board as a parent volunteer. Ms. Korbelak did as well. She had four students in the system and has been there for a while. And I have five students currently in the system across four different schools. So I've volunteered at a lot of places. I started off this year, I just figured out, was the first year in over a decade that I did not work a shift at the book fair. And I kind of missed it. I realized there was a gap there, but instead I've migrated into being a high school band parent, which is a whole different world in and of itself. So I understand all that parent volunteers do, and I just want to say thank you. Every year I'm just in awe when I hear of the fabulous programs that the volunteers run at our schools. We could not be doing what we do now without you and without all you give. And it truly takes a village, and you are a vital part of that village. So thank you to everyone.
Thank you, Ms. Hummer, for your words, and also thank you for all your years of volunteerism. We appreciate that. Our school system is dedicated today to celebrating all the wonderful things by volunteers in our schools. This year, the week of April 15th through the 21st was officially National Volunteer Week. Each year, the Points of Light Foundation sets the theme. The foundation strengthened its ties to our government during the presidency of George H.W. Bush. I bring this up because, as we all know, Barbara Bush passed away this year, so I would like to honor the Bush's commitment to the power of volunteerism by sharing with you something Barbara Bush once said. Volunteering and community service is a lot like planting peonies. You may not see the results right away. Indeed, you may never see them, but you never know when you will plant a seed that one day will sprout and bloom forever. This quote is as appropriate this week as any. We want to support our students to develop into caring, competent, and contributing citizens. We strive to do work to make the goal come true, but we don't always have the opportunity to know what fruit our work bears. So it is appropriate that the theme for National Volunteer Week this year is Celebrate Service. Today, we are gathered here to celebrate the people who come together to make a difference for our students. When you look at the program, you will find the names of over 800, and this is the program you picked up when you came in, 800 volunteers in our awardees list. Please take the time to look at all their names. If you are like me, you will be amazed at the number of individuals who have given incredible amounts of time to our students. This year marks 10 years or more of service for 84 volunteers, and just over 200 volunteers can claim that they gave 300 hours or more this year. Believe it or not, the numbers are probably much higher. After all, many volunteers choose not to turn in their hours. Can you imagine what the numbers would be if we really had all of the volunteers count all of their hours? All of you are such a gift to our students. This is also the time that I ask you for a personal favor. Don't let the celebration end here. Please spread the joy when you go back to your schools. Take the time to help celebrate the service given by all of the volunteers that work to make a difference, but couldn't come to this event. Let the volunteers who didn't come know that we appreciate the gift of their time and their talents. We know that they are part of the effort that happens each and every day at our schools. So take a moment to thank a volunteer back at your own school. Share the joy, continue the celebration. Our event always starts with a focus on individual volunteers in our system, but each and every one of you should know how grateful we are. We also know the power that comes together when we all work together. Programs, thanks to our volunteers. This is the time in the program that we're going to hear about some of those programs. It is tradition in our county to start the awards by recognizing one truly outstanding program that makes a difference. The program usually stands out in the judges' minds as an exceptional program. The award it receives is known as the Crystal Apple Award. Today we are honored to have Victoria Samuels, who is with us to present the award. Ms. Samuels is the Vice President of Community Relations for Educational Systems Federal Credit Union. Started in 1955 by a group of school system volunteers, this credit union still proudly serves as our education community, or serves our community. This group is the valedictorian sponsor of the 21st Century Education Foundation. The foundation is a nonprofit organization that supports Anne Arundel County Public Schools. We are fortunate to have an organization that serves not only the employees of the school system, but also our students and their families. We are so pleased that Victoria Samuels was able to join us today to present the Crystal Apple. Vic?
There you go. Good morning, everyone. This is truly a wonderful day to say thank you. Thank you, Teresa. I, too, want to welcome you to this wonderful celebration. I feel so privileged to work for a group that tries to positively touch the lives of all of us involved in making a brighter future for our students. I am honored to have a part in today's celebration. As you may know, one of the driving values for Anne Arundel County Public Schools is to help our students develop into caring and contributing citizens. We want those future citizens prepared to positively impact their world. Today, we will honor a program that helps students believe that they can and do make a difference to their world. This year, the Crystal Apple Award goes to the Green Apple Day of Service at South Shore Elementary. Could the representatives from that program please come forward while I share some details about this program? Here they come. We are so fortunate to live in part of the Chesapeake Bay watershed. We are one of six states that share responsibility for the health and well-being of this area that plays such a large role in the life of our citizens. South Shore Elementary, chose to embrace our role as caregiver to the Bay by using volunteers to help organize a full day of special environmental events. This program reinforced lessons about the environment through a variety of subjects. For example, students used art to paint and place a rock for the newly constructed rock garden. I smile because I have a rock garden too. And my family has to keep weeding it. You know, I arrange it, but they have to work it. The community involved AAC, Waste Management, sent volunteers to discuss the reduce, reuse, and recycle program. Students even used recycled cardboard milk cartons to make a viewable root planting. And during lunch, students had the opportunity to watch a video of the terrapin the fifth grade class is raising for release. I think that is so cool. It is with great pleasure that I recognize a program that does indeed work to help our students begin now to positively impact their world. In recognition of the Green Apple Day of Service program, I have the pleasure of presenting South Shore Elementary with this crystal apple and certificate. Congratulations. What are we taking? Is this a picture? Oh. Honey?
Thank you, Ms. Samuels, for helping us recognize this outstanding program. Next, our regional assistant superintendents would also like to recognize outstanding programs from their own regions. First, we will hear from Ms. Jolynn Davis, the regional assistant superintendent for the schools in the Annapolis and Broadnet clusters. Ms. Davis.
Good morning. I must tell you, it is always difficult to single out one program from all of the amazing things happening in our schools. We all have many, many programs helping make a difference for our students, but I still have to announce just one exemplary program from my region. So I ask that the representatives from the Panther Leaders Program at Mills Parole Elementary come forward while I tell you a bit about the program. You might know that the Annapolis High team mascot is the Panther. The program at Mills Parole is the Panther Leaders because male student athletes from Annapolis High volunteer to work with fifth grade boys. Wearing their team jerseys, these athletes work with fifth graders following an interactive read aloud format. They discuss the text as they're reading to the students. Afterwards, they have a book discussion and enjoy snacks. Most importantly, the fifth graders at Mills Parole have the opportunity to build a positive relationship with a male role model. But it doesn't stop there. In addition to supporting literacy, the Panthers also address the Mills Parole Way with the fifth graders. This includes discussing ways to show respect, be responsible, and be ready to learn. The program does not just address literacy and the social needs of the fifth graders. A recent program evaluation given to our high school athletes showed that it was also promoting our value of preparing students to be caring and contributing citizens. The athletes indicated they will be more likely to volunteer in their community in the future. I am very pleased to present the Mills Parole Elementary team with this plaque in recognition of your wonderful program that supports literacy as well as the development of caring, competent, and contributing citizens. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Davis. Didn't they all look so wonderful? We're really proud of them. We will now hear from Mr. Chris Truffer, the Regional Assistant Superintendent of the Schools in the Arundel and South River Clusters. Mr. Truffer.
Thank you, Teresa, and good morning. I've taken a little walk down memory lane. I recognize these two twins here. You guys remember me from Rolling Knolls back in the day when you were... They were shorter then, but their faces were identical. I still remember them, so thanks, guys. I would be remiss also if I didn't recognize and echo Dr. Arlotto's comments about Dr. Kubik and Ray Bebo. Dr. Kubik, thank you for all your leadership and guidance. Ray, just thank you for being Ray over the years. That's been more than enough. Thank you. Also, someone reminded me my hair was black when I started presenting these recognitions a long time ago. So good morning, everyone. I am very pleased and honored to be here this morning and to have the opportunity to recognize a very special volunteer program from one of the schools in my region. As has been stated numerous times, we do have a new strategic plan, and I can say with a strong level of confidence that our values of all means all and ready, set, launch are strongly supported by the Wall Chapel program we are highlighting this morning. Embedded within those values is a clear expectation that literacy is embraced and that all community members own literacy instruction and share a role in ensuring our young learners are engaged in these literacy opportunities. As the representatives from Wall Chapel Elementary come forward, I want to tell you about their special program, Mystery Reader Days. And I did warn them that the stage feels like it's moving. It's not collapsing, it just likes to move around when people are up here, so. One way to encourage literacy is by sharing stories with children. Interestingly, stories are another hallmark of our new strategic plan. Many schools have guest reader programs. However, Wall Chapel Elementary decided to enhance this program, so they implemented Mystery Reader Days. Volunteers signed up to guest read, and I was signed up as one of those guest readers and had the opportunity to visit, but they were not announced to the classes. This certainly increased the level of excitement about the guest readers who were coming to visit. Often, children would be found sneaking to their classroom doors to peek out to see if they would recognize someone coming down the hallway to visit their classroom. This program not only promotes reading, but it was also an opportunity for family members to volunteer in classrooms ranging from pre-K to fifth grade. Needless to say, this program created excitement among the students, engagement in reading, and was an outstanding accompaniment to their already robust and very powerful literacy instruction. I am very pleased this morning to present our team from Wall Chapel with the plaque that I know Teresa is holding. In recognition of your efforts, I am sure that everyone would like to join me in recognizing the Mystery Reader Days program that provides support to literacy instruction. Congratulations.
I think every volunteer that comes up here really thinks this stage is going to collapse. We promise it won't. I hope. Thank you, Chris. Next up is Dr. Anthony Alston, and this is a new title for him recently. We will also want to congratulate him on his PhD. Dr. Alston is the Regional Assistant Superintendent for the schools in the Chesapeake and Northeast Cluster.
So I, too, am honored to be here and to be able to wish you all a good morning. It is truly a pleasure and a privilege to acknowledge all the amazing things that are happening in schools throughout the Chesapeake and North County clusters. It's always hard to single out just one program for the Exemplary Program Award. This year, I am also recognizing a program that supports literacy. I would like the representatives from Linthicum Elementary School to please come forward as I share some of the amazing information about the Read Across America Readathon. All of our schools have programs that encourage reading. Mrs. Parks at Linthicum Elementary School chose to build interest in a very unique way. She instituted a readathon. Yes, just like a walkathon, this program raises money based on how much each entrant reads. In this case, each minute spent reading is equivalent to miles. These miles were not only tracked as a journey across the world, they also added up to money raised for the school. This program has been in place for 4 years. In that time, they have raised over $18,000.
Yeah, right.
Of course, it not only supports in the cause of literacy, it also encourages and supports the needs of the school. The Readathon is now one of the biggest, most successful school-wide events at Linthicum Elementary. I am very pleased to present with you this plaque in recognition of your efforts to encourage literacy. I am sure that everyone here would like to join me in applauding this outstanding program.
Thank you, Dr. Alston. Our next regional assistant superintendent is Ms. Janine Robinson, who oversees the schools in the Glen Burnie and Severna Park clusters.
Good morning. It is always such a pleasure to be able to share this day with so many people who take the time to help our students succeed. As I am sure you know, there are many roads to success. One of our driving values, as already noted, is to build programs that help students become contributing adults who can successfully and positively impact our society. The exemplary program from my area certainly helps us work toward that goal. So let me ask the representatives from Oak Hill Elementary to come forward while I share some amazing information about their program, Heroes on the Half Shell. This year, Oak Hill Elementary was chosen by the Maryland State Bar Association for participation in their program that focuses on improving the health of the Chesapeake Bay while educating students about the bay and their role in keeping it healthy. Unfortunately, one of the attorneys who started the program could not be with us today because she's in court hearing three cases. Five volunteers from the Maryland Bar Association, as well as the Education Outreach Liaison from the Oyster Recovery Partnership, came to Oak Hill to do hands-on lessons with our fourth grade students. Their objective is to use oysters to educate students about the Chesapeake Bay, its ecosystem, and the important role we all play in the bay's overall recovery. The lessons teach students that they have a personal impact on the bay and the importance of oysters in our watershed. The students extended their learning beyond the classroom by reaching out to restaurants and organizations, collecting oyster shells, and sharing what they learned. In 1 month's time, Oak Hill students and faculty brought in more than 100 bushels of oyster shells to be donated to the Oyster Recovery Partnership. Those shells will stay out of the local landfills. They will become substrate to support new oyster beds in our local waters. I am very pleased to present you with this plaque in recognition of Heroes on the Half Shell program at Oak Hill Elementary School. I am sure that everyone would like to join me in recognizing this exemplary program.
Thank you. It's okay. Here. Our next presenter is the Regional Assistant Superintendent for the Mead and Southern Clusters, Mr. Ray Bebo.
Good morning. When he lowered it, I guess he thought he knew I was coming up next, so he thought he'd put it down a little bit. I still can't believe that you let me have a mic. All these years, and they put a mic in front of me, and it's my last year, so you never know what I'm going to say. So be careful when you say things about me, because I get the mic. Dr. Arlotto, thank you. Kind words. It's just been a great opportunity to work for Anne Arundel County for 40 years. Especially grateful for your leadership. And I'm so pleased at how smart this school board is, that got it right 2 times in a row. So thank you all. So we've come a long way. The people I'm going to honor today work at NSA. And I've been around a long time, and to know that you didn't actually say NSA a long time ago. You worked at DOD, right? You worked on Fort Meade. You worked at the agency. You never said where you were from. So it's interesting how far we've evolved that we're able to actually talk about it now. And one of the things that's really great about this is when I started in 1978, I was a teacher. I taught mathematics.
Good job.
Taught mathematics. You know, the kids always said, when are we ever going to use this? And finally, I got people who actually use this. So thank you. And so good morning. So I want to direct your attention back to our driving values. And the important part of that is the all means all. And, you know, all of you, as well as all of us, right? And so the volunteers are such an important part of this, of our journey and really the values that drive us as a school system and as human beings. So in that, I think it's a very smart value and one that I cherish, and I know the school system does, and we believe, and I think that with the help of stakeholders, we actually will get there. So I'm very pleased, and therefore, I'd ask the representatives from Mead Middle to come forward as I tell you a little bit about their exemplary program with our NSA agency partners and education. Where's Mead? Employees of the National Security Agency visit Mead Middle School on a weekly basis to tutor students in all grade levels and all subject areas. ESOL and math students in particular have benefited greatly from the services, as students are able to work one-on-one in small groups to get homework done or to work on STEM challenges. Students are provided opportunities to build relationships with adults who are utilizing these skills that the students are learning in their work on a daily basis. This is truly one of the great opportunities to answer that burning question, when are we ever going to need this? This partnership not only helps students grow to reach their potential, it also shows them that the skills they are learning will be of use to them as they become independent adults. I'm very pleased to present you with this plaque. You're not getting my flowers, but you'll get the plaque. In recognition of the NSA Partners in Education program. Congratulations, and please give them a round of applause. Who's up next? Am I done?
I'm sure someone up there that is streaming this live is, we're really playing havoc with them doing this back and forth with the mic, but it's necessary. Thank you, Mr. Bebo. I've known Mr. Bebo for a long time. He was in my wedding, actually, and I walked down the aisle, and what did I see? He had one job to do, light the candles. The candles were not lit, that's all I'm gonna say. I don't think I am. Dr. Lucarelli is the Regional Assistant Superintendent of the Northeast and Old Mill Clusters. She will now share with you the exemplary program winner from that region.
And I have to follow that. Good morning. It's a pleasure to be here with everyone today and have the opportunity to celebrate the wonderful things going on in our schools. I'm recognizing a volunteer program that exemplifies the importance of literacy for the future success of our students. I'd like to have the representatives from Severn Elementary and the STAIR volunteers come forward while I share some information about the program STAIR, Start the Adventure in Reading. STAIR is a proven reading and mentoring program designed to provide early intervention for at-risk second graders. Students work one-on-one with STAIR tutors twice a week after school for 1 hour. The program not only works to increase reading fluency and comprehension, but provides a caring environment to promote each student's sense of self-worth and esteem. This program truly turns reluctant readers into confident, competent, lifelong readers. I had the opportunity to actually see this program in action and attend the STAIR graduation. Firsthand, I was filled with emotion as I watched the students read in front of all kinds of just adults, a room full of adults. They're standing there, they're reading. They shared poetry they had written. They shared a play together. It was simply amazing the confidence that this program has built in the students. The smiles on the faces of the students and the volunteer tutors was priceless. I'm very pleased to present the STAIR program and Severn Elementary with the plaque behind me in recognition of your partnership that encourages the love, the joy, and the mastery of reading. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Lucarelli. Next on today's program is Terry Shaner, who would present the Brenda Shaner Legacy Award. Terry, I see you down. He's coming this way. This is an award that was started a few years ago in memory of Brenda Shaner. Brenda's a phenomenal volunteer. She was also an educator. And she worked at Tyler Heights as a volunteer with the Backpack Buddies for years and just did amazing things at the school. Terry?
Thank you for those nice words. Well, hello, fellow volunteers. Good morning. And educators, good morning. We hold you in great admiration. And in a way, this award is about admiration. I wanted to first of all say the best cheerleader that volunteers ever had, thank you so much. I think I'm going to give her an applause. I'm always working to get on her good side. Brenda Shaner was a lifelong teacher, including 27 years in Anne Arundel County Schools. In retirement, she was a dedicated Right Start advisor and founder of one of our first Backpack Buddies programs. Like other teachers, Brenda had a vision of teaching that it was more than a job, that it was a calling, and it is actually the very discovery of the purpose for which some of us have been created. Her commitment as an educator left behind a legacy, and that's the foundation of the Legacy Award, to annually recognize one practicing educator, a teacher, an administrator, a staff member, or a volunteer whose work is noticeably creating a legacy in public education. The nominee this year is a student instructional support teacher. A small sampling of her work includes operating a huge free cycle clothing giveaway, being fully engaged as a staff liaison to Backpack Buddies and a host of other volunteer groups, several of which come from her church, arranging scholarships for children for summer camps. And I have a check for you today for that. Supporting teachers under heavy pressure, including taking their class as needed. She's constantly adopting one of the children for special attention. She is gifted with energy, personality, joy, competence, community building, skill. The Legacy Award recipient this year is Kimberly Stanger, now serving her 12th year at Tyler Heights Elementary. Clearly creating quite a legacy.
Thank you, Terry. And thank you, Kimmy, for all that you do. I've worked with her, I guess, for those 12 years that she's been at Tyler, and she does amazing things for the students at Tyler High. As we approach the end of our program, I want to take a moment to make a special presentation. Today is a time to celebrate all the people who give so much to our schools. As we go through all the names and lists, there will always be that one volunteer who really stands out. That individual becomes our Volunteer of the Year. Volunteerism is a powerful practice, one that has become a prized and essential part of Anne Arundel County Public Schools community. Our district and school leaders, faculty, and staff can all attest that the dynamic opportunities we aim to offer our students could never be fully realized without the commitment and partnership of volunteers who want our students to excel just as much as we do. Our Volunteer of the Year is the embodiment of this selflessness and dedication, a true representative of the power of volunteerism that helps propel our students and schools toward greatness each day. Michelle Fowler, we are honored today to celebrate 15 years of your dedication to Anne Arundel County Public Schools. As Michelle's family comes forward, and Michelle, if you would come up here, Let me tell you a little bit about Michelle's journey with the Anne Arundel County Public Schools. It started when her son Jackson began attending Linthicum Elementary School in 2003. After joining the Parent Teacher Association, she quickly became a reliable resource for the school, helping to organize events that promoted literacy, teacher appreciation, and the arts. Jenny Ford, a parent volunteer who has worked closely with Michelle, lauded her work ethic as she shared. Michelle keeps working on something until it is just right. She has a way with words that generally allows her to successfully accomplish her goals, which are always towards the needs of students. Over the years, Michelle's commitment to supporting students and schools traveled the North County theater system right along with her children. At Lindale Middle School, Ms. Fowler continued to support school-wide activities, including honor roll events, book fairs, and she also gave special time and attention to the music and theater programs. She worked closely with teachers to organize performances and coordinate musical festivals and productions. Her former principal, George Lindley, shared that he can fondly recall her support of students and staff while he served at Lindale Middle. Fortunately, Michelle's support of music and school leadership did not stop with Lindale. Current director of school performance and former principal of North County High School, Julie Cares, appreciated Mrs. Fowler as not only a volunteer, but also as a close advisor who was always willing to offer a parent and community perspective about ideas to benefit students and the school. Mrs. Cares shared that her principalship, and as a result, North County High School, benefited from every interaction with Mrs. Fowler. We can celebrate our Volunteer of the Year for the countless events that she has coordinated to help students reach their learning goals, for the way she has advanced and advocated for music and the arts in both word and deed, or perhaps for the way she has valued and supported our school leaders and teachers as they work to offer their very best to students over the years. No matter which example we choose, one thing is clear. Our school system has been better because of you, Michelle Fowler. We are exceptionally grateful to have benefited from 15 years of your service, and we are proud to honor you with the 2018 Volunteer of the Year Award. We snuck her mom in at the end. We didn't want her to see her at the beginning. And so here we are at the end of another year full of the stories of the good you have done for our students. Through countless acts of kindness and service, you work with us to move our school system forward. Thank you for all you do. You truly are the best examples of works of heart. Let's have one last round of applause for all of us working together to make a difference for our students. I am glad that you could celebrate with us today. As always, I wish you a safe trip home and a good summer. And remember, there are lots of students, teachers, and staff, and other volunteers who look forward to seeing you throughout the coming school year to help us help our students succeed. I'm sure I'll see you next year. Have a great summer.